For the King beta. It is a beta. So this lets us know that they're still working on it. They're still polishing it, but I find it to be quite fantastic after my initial test. Let's give it a shot. Local cooperative, that sounds pretty cool. I'll have to try that sometime. But for now, it's solo adventure. All right, so it looks like I've got a party already named. The Adventures of Robin, Arlene, and Tim. I can't tell if Arlene is a chick or a dude. I guess it's not really important. Let's just get it going. The brink of chaos. The land of Farul has enjoyed a golden age. But an unknown enemy is in their midst and chaos has been unleashed. And we've got to leave our homes and answer the call. All right, the tale begins in the Guardian Forest. We are going to enable helpers because this is the second time I've played. All right, Rossamon is the queen. She says we're going to look out her agents in Agiero. They're going to tell us how to best help. All right, here we go. Once you receive a quest, you must complete it before the end of the night. Otherwise, the kingdoms will be swallowed alive by the impending chaos. So, as you can see at the top of the screen here, we have a time of day meter. It starts out in the daytime. And here is the chaos meter that can go up from zero chaos right now to four. I've only seen one chaos, and I don't think I'm really excited to see more. One chaos meant that an evil leprechaun was randomly stealing my quest rewards, the loot drops from my enemies. Not fun. Let's see here. It's day one, it's raining, and apparently there's tentacles about. I don't know what that means. Alright, so we have a quest to get from here, Orton, to Agiero. Let's see if we can do it. It's a new party objective. Failure to complete it will unleash chaos into the world. You have to complete it within a certain amount of time. I haven't quite figured out how much time you actually have. Alright, go to Agiero. So this game is played out in turns, and just about everything you do will involve a roll. They call them slots, but they're really like dice rolls. For instance, this person just tested it's Tim's turn. So his quickness was tested, and he won all five rolls, giving him the maximum of five movement points. So we are going to take Tim up toward Agiero. Now to get there, we're going to have to go around this area here, and these clouds will lift as we approach. I really want to stop here. That'll give him a conviction multiplier plus 15%. Okay, I don't know what conviction is, and I don't know what it does, but I want it. Let's actually double check, though. Conviction. You've got toughness, vitality, fortitude, awareness, talent, and quickness. Now these, to some extent, I think these are determined by the class that you pick initially. Here's evasion, resistance, armor, attack damage, focus, which is an interesting thing that'll come into play later, and health. Still no idea what conviction is or what it does for you. All right then, well, he's going to devote himself to the Sanctum of Wisdom. The Goddess of Wisdom, Valencine, has given him 4 XP and a conviction multiplier of plus 15%. Great. All Alright, a nice day. This is great. Randomly, when you hit the end of your movement, you'll get a nice day and it'll give you extra movement points. How nice is that? Boat dock is where we can purchase or repair ocean vessels. How much is an ocean vessel, anyway? Ship deed is 50 gold. That seems nice. Don't really need one now. So we'll just wait. Now, Tim is not hurt. If he were hurt, I could save his movement points and he would heal a proportionate amount. I believe he would heal one, but since his health's full, we're just going to end our turn. Alright. Some monsters have popped up. I don't know if you saw that. It happened very quickly. And, alright. Our attributes were tested, and we succeeded 4 out of 5 times, meaning she's got 4 movement points. Go, Arlene, go. Oh! Ambushed by a wolf. I only have one option to defend myself. Hopefully I will get some help from Robin, who is nearby. Alright, combat's determined by the time slider that shows who is going to act first. There are proficiency attacks. They come with a penalty to accuracy, but can have a devastating effect if they're successful. Those which require full slots are criticals. Okay, interesting. Now, I've recently learned that you can... These are slots. And a smash attack with this weapon will use 4 slots. So each one is like a check of my toughness ability. And if successful, there we go, 3 out of 4 were successful. So I did 75% damage. Really? He gets to attack twice. Now you can, I've learned, use these focus points. They're very cool. And the focus will actually lock in your attack here. Let's see if I can do it. Focus. Right click to focus, and that means that I'm definitely going to hit this guy hard. I wonder if I can undo focus. It looks like once it's done, it's done. So I just wasted my focus points on that wolf, but that's okay. He had it coming. Alright, we're going to collect this golden root. That's our first piece of loot. It looks like that will actually replenish some focus for Arlene. That might be handy. We'll think about using that later. I want to see if she can get it back by resting or any other means. Alright, we're going to finish her turn at the Shrine of Wisdom. It's already been claimed by Tim. And turn over. Robin's turn. Alright, Robin rolled 3 out of 5. Or Robin's 5 slots. It's hard to get used to that. Robin's gonna walk up. A nice day. Hey, that's great. Get nice and close here. Alright. With each passing round, time will tick forward 1 bar. Quest-related events will be marked on the time bar and become active at the beginning of the round. Different events, different enemies and events take place during day and night. Each new day enemies become more difficult and shops will restock their supplies. Oh boy. Alright. Tim's turn. Tim got a pretty good roll. Ooh, a dark carnival. That's fun. But we need to get to Ayero. Tim's feeling good. Could check, I already checked for boats. 50 gold. A little expensive. Arlene, full 5-point roll. Excellent. There's a cellar over there. A descent into the underworld. That's exciting. We have to check that out later. If we live. Of course we're gonna live. What am I talking about? Alright. Robin. rolled 4 out of 5. That's great. We're almost together. Robin found some Godsbeard. Godsbeard, the herbalists seem to find things when they walk around in the overworld. I think Godsbeard might heal the party. Yes. Herbalists can use it to heal the entire party. It's really nice. What is that? Something unknown. It could be anything. I can't resist. I need to know. Oh, I've been ambushed by a dire crow. Alright. Oh, and he's alone. Yikes. That's okay. Tim's tough. He's got this. If I get all three of these slots, it should do all 6 damage and kill the dire crow, if it hits it. Tim wasn't into that plan. Instead, he did 2 damage. The crow just stole my teleport scroll. Now it's personal. But once again, Tim is underwhelming. Right, the dire crow totally wet the bed and missed completely. Failure to launch. But it did dodge my attack. Oh, that's bad. So the dire crow stole my teleport scroll and escaped. I find myself in a verdant clearing where many useful plants grow. I'd do well to stock up. Okay, and apparently this depends on focus. Let's give it a shot. I don't know if I'd get another chance if I used another character. Yeah! Godsbeard. That is good. I can give that to my herbalist, Robin, and Robin could... Oh, look at that. Apparently I can't access my inventory. Alright, that's fine. What is this other item? Tim, what's in your inventory? Godsbeard? A couple of them. That's fantastic. I wonder if I'm close enough to send it to my friend. Nope. Alright, ending the turn. These crows are getting close. Arlene is gonna just go right through this guy. Arlene is actually very tough. It looks like she would have a very poor chance of ambushing or sneaking past this guy. Yeah, let's fight it. Alright, the whole party's here. This is good news. Bandit Archer doesn't stand a chance unless I just roll everything bad. Tim, you're really letting me down. Alright, here comes a blast from... No, that was Arlene. Tim! No, I have no idea. That's Robin. Okay, good job. Our blacksmith, Arlene, is going to finish this guy off. Yeah, critical hit. A bandit bow. Do I have anybody who can use a bow? I don't know, but that's really cool. It uses... A skill that none of my people are currently utilizing. Wow, it even has a slash attack. That's great. Support combat range. I don't know what that means. Maybe you get to move to the back row. Let's equip that and just find out what happens. Oh my. Now that's nice. 10 magic damage. Yeah. That's definitely going to Tim. Some shoes. Robin has traditionally been wrecked the most, so we'll give her some more defense. Alright. So, Arlene. is gonna just take another step. Whoa, the birds are out in force. Now I need to check Arlene's stats. She actually has a pretty high awareness skill, and that's what the bandit bow uses. She's only going to get a 2-slot roll, but that means her attack will either do nothing, 50%, or 100% damage. With other weapons, like the cane that she had, it's got 4 slots. See that 4 slots? And those are 4 fortitude slots. That could do nothing, 25%, 50%, 75%, or 100%. Alright. We need to wreck a crow. That's what I think. Now, we have a chance to try and ambush it. And there's actually a 41% chance that we could do this, so we're gonna go for it. Oh, fail. We failed to ambush it. And we've got 3 crows. I don't know if failure is worse than walking away and not attempting it, but... Alright. Attack all for 8 points. I could focus this attack and just wreck these guys good. I think I'm gonna do it. I only need 6 points. And that is how you take care of crows, folks. Wow, a shiny pendant. Talent plus 3%. Let's give it to Tim. Max focus plus 1. Arlene needs that. Look at that. From 3 to 4 focus. What cool items. Getting some really neat drops this time. I think it's time to go to Ayera. Alright, we reached it in time. No chaos attributed. Alright, evil folks in the Guardian Forest. Uh-oh. Have to kill the acolyte in the Guardian Forest. Which is, by some strange random occurrence, right next to my party. Alright, Robin's got 8 gold. Let's see what's going on in the town market. Some God's Beard would be nice because she can use it to heal the whole party. However, there are weapons to be had for just a little more money. Like a plus 2 quarterstaff. Or a plus 2 shortbow. That's looking pretty nice. I think the best idea here would be to see if I can get somebody to pass me money and buy some good stuff. Alright, we're gonna move Tim a couple spaces. Arlene has full roll. So I'm going to have Arlene... Oh, she's not close enough. I'm going to have Arlene pass some money to Robin. We'll just give it all to her. And then we'll get back in place to wreck this guy. End our turn. That should gain us some health since we didn't use all our action points. Alright, Robin has full action points. She's gonna buy something. Need to make the best choice here. Some nice stuff. This bow, I don't know. Yeah, it's not, it is plus 2 bow. Does that mean anything? I think I'm gonna keep mine. Mine has more damage potential. Plus 1 short sword. Doesn't seem better than any of the weapons that I have. An identify scroll. Contrary to most games, this reveals the identity of an unknown landmark. That might be nice. Next time I send an herb gatherer in, it could be my herbalist. Okay. I'm gonna buy a god's beard. So I can heal the party up. They're looking pretty ragged. Got a quest board. Kill the cut purse for 30 gold? Sure. There's the cut purse. Looks like a rat. It's a side quest, that's good. Risks and rewards vary greatly. Alright, well, let's take this acolyte out. Sneaking. 17% chance of success? I don't think so. We're gonna fight it. These guys are looking tough. 20 plus hit points. But they're not hitting Arlene all that hard. Arlene's good. It is Tim's turn. Tim, let's take out the guy with pitchfork. He looks like a threat. Group attack could do 8 damage to everyone. Accuracy is just too low to risk, though. Alright. Steadfast. I don't know how you get that, but my blacksmith just completely ignored the damage. Alright. First time using this bow. It looks like I've got a 12 damage and 74% accuracy. That's great. However, my party is hurt. I'm gonna heal them. 7 HP, not bad. Smash this guy. Sounds like a girl. Drained 3 HP. Oh, set Arlene on fire. Thanks for not doing that again. I'm gonna risk a group attack. I think I'm gonna empower it. Oh, this is Tim. Alright. Yes. 1 down, 2 to go. Wow. They're hitting really hard. Maybe I should have healed up before I came to this fight. Maybe. Okay, I'm starting to see an advantage to having a weapon with only a few of these slots in the attack. I can use 2 to empower it and guarantee hits. Next, focus. Come on, let me focus. I don't know what the problem is. There we go. It looks like you need to right-click on this icon. Okay, apparently some armor blocked that. And that's why the person did not die immediately. Still not enough to take that guy down. That was really sad. Steadfast. Love it. Okay, group attack. Tim, I need to finish this guy off. Excellent. Alright. Job done. We've got a well-detailed map of the local area. We're gonna collect that. Okay, so Hildebrandt's looking at the map we were carrying. It appears to reveal the location of something they're keeping secret in the Guardian Forest. Let's put an end to it. Well, that's right on the way. We just need to take out that cut purse on the way. But if we don't get some healing soon, we're going to be in big trouble. I don't think we're going to make it. I need to get to a town, and I think, So, gotta move forward, or backward, to heal. Yikes. I think I've only got... How many healing herbs do I have left? Well, I guess I have to end my turn. Alright, Tim's turn. Tim's got a healing herb. He needs to give that up. Both of them. Give it to the herbalist. Beautiful. Alright. Now Robin can heal up soon. We're gonna walk past this bird. No. He's not very good at sneaking. 31% chance. Let's try. Oh my goodness. He's snuck by. Pretty lucky roll. Alright, Arlene only gets 3 movement points. I think that's okay. She's hurt really bad. And Robin. 4 movement points, nice. Let's see if she can heal Arlene somehow. Nope, but Robin managed to heal herself. I swear I sent her 2. Oh, there we go. We use 1. We're going to give 1 to our critically wounded blacksmith. And we're looking good. Alright. 41% chance of success to ambush that direcrow. We gotta take it. Alright. Hi, direcrow. How's it going? Ooh, dodge. Just had to damage Arlene, too. Arlene, no, it's Tim. Okay. And a blast attack. This shot to finish off that crow. That's how we deal with crows. I'm really liking the art. It's something new. This game actually seems like it would be very good for like the Xbox. It'd be fun to play multiplayer, especially. Kind of reminds me of a board game, and I love board games. All right, heading to the boat dock. All right, we've cleared the way. Goes Tim, without incident. Arlene is hurt really bad. I think I'm gonna need to have her heal up a little. Yeah. That's looking better. We can't waste time. And I'm glad I did. Because it's a timber wolf. Good dodge. Alright, let's smash this thing. Alright. And another God's Beard. We're just going to heal up. This relieves the effects of poison. I'm going to collect this Panax. I wonder if that's what Panacea comes from. Okay. Nothing going on at the boat dock. Robin's got 4 movement points. Let's get the party together. Robin's had good success with crows. I'm just gonna jump right on it. We're gonna try to ambush again. Look at that. Total success. We're gonna get first shot. Oh, it really does dodge well, that crow. Let's see if we can get a hit. There we go. Take that, crow. 3 awareness. I have no idea what awareness is for, but Robin would love it. All right, Tim, good roll, sir. We need to kill that cut purse. B for more info. Let's see. S is additional stats. Let's try that. Oh, look at that. That's pretty cool. I'm gonna just leave that on. Got weapon damage. Statistics. Very nice. Oh, that awareness. That just upped Robin's ability to use that bow. Alright, we're heading to town. But we've met a crone. A level 0 crone. Alright. I think she just tried to poison me. And I take offense to that. She successfully poisoned me. Take that, crone. Alright, that'll give me a boost to XP. Let's just use it. Could possibly go wrong. Tim's poisoned. He doesn't have anything to fix that at the moment, but he's going into town here. Let's see what we can do. A healer could remove our ailments and fully restore our HP. Blessing's gonna remove all curses. I think a healer is good right now. Get rid of that poison. Alright, Arlene. That's a terrible roll. Alright. The Wisdom Shrine's already been claimed by Tim. Alright, Robin's got 4. That's enough to get Robin into town. And Robin needs the town pretty bad. Services. A modest amount of HP and focus. Yeah, that seems nice. All HP and 2 focus, that's nice. It's getting dark, and if we don't finish that quest soon, we'll really be in trouble. So it looks like I've got 4 more turns to get this figured out. I need Arlene down here to really tackle this. Oh boy. It's a level 1, which is going to be more powerful than us. But we're healed up. Let's give it a shot. Fight. Wow. Robin did not like that. Okay, level 16 HP on the cut purse. Quest objective. Tim has got 1 focus. I say we use it. Alright. Robin's got some focus. I need to hit this guy for 7 points. That means I need both of these to go off. Let's get it done. That's an X cut purse right there. Alright. Victory! Quest completed, but now we have to solve the cult device. Let's give it a shot, man. Oh boy. There's only a 3% chance of him solving that. We need Arlene down there. Tim's still looking good, so I think I'm just going to have him pass his money over to Robin. Can I type? No. But you can hold down the button, and that's nice. Alright, Robin will buy something later. We're going to end turn there. Arlene, please roll. Oh, that's a terrible roll. Not what we needed. Alright. Gonna buy something at the market. Let's see what we've got here. Alright. Wooden staff, plus two. I wonder how that would look with Tim. Tim's currently got a wooden staff, plus two. So I don't think that's gonna help much. A quarter staff. Nah, that's weak. I'm not seeing a whole lot here. Simple hat. That could be nice. Some boots. I've already got some boots. I could buy them for somebody else, but those are common. I think some more God's Beard is going to be a good idea. We're going to buy all the God's Beard. Alright. Now we can heal the party effectively. Robin should probably heal. Alright. Come on, Arlene. Tim can't handle this. Something unknown, though. A stone circle could give us more focus or destroy our XP. Or a fight! Wow. Lose all XP. Wow, that was a lot of XP, too. That was like 12 XP. Impressive work, Hosehead. You're done. Alright, Arlene, please roll more than three. Okay. We're gonna fix this cult device. Total success. Machine crumbles. I've unlocked the glittering mines. Go see what we can find there, but be careful. I'm sure those shifty folk in robes were up to no good. Alright. Purge the glittering mines. Sounds like a movie I heard about. I wonder if anybody's got a teleport scroll. Guess not. That's a pretty good move, though. Tim, do you have one? I think a crow stole his teleport scroll. Yep. Not a thing. It's Bone Archer time. It's just one of them. And we're dodging. Because that's how we do. Let's blast this fool. Critical hit. No, that's not good. Oh, another dodge. It's like a dodge fest up in here. Why can't I dodge twice? Okay. That's bad. Okay, that's three shots of 11. It might be worth your while to hit that bone archer this time, buddy. Thanks. Good move. Look at those arrows sticking through his hat. That must have really grazed him. Does he have any healing? No. I don't know if Tim's gonna make it, folks. Alright, Arlene has made it. Robin has 4 points. So from what I can tell, the landscape is procedurally generated. The layout, everything about it, based on the last game. So you really don't know what you're going to get. The Bone Trickster Camp. Multiple enemies. I don't think I want to go to there. I think our best action would be to avoid all this stuff and head straight to the Glittering Mines. Why am I spending my... Oh, weird. Hey, look at that. Max focus up 1. So, this is a beta, and apparently if you right click on the world map, it will spend your focus on nothing. At least I think that was nothing that I got for that. Here's a Dark Carnival. I don't have time for Dark Carnivals. I need to get to this mine before time runs out. Level 2 Bone Tricksters. I'm gonna try and ambush it because I don't have time to retreat. Oh, that's bad. I think I might have had some time after all. 3 hit points. Running away. And it's total fail. Robin bit the big one. It's not the first time Robin's completely wet the bed when trying to make some rolls. Much evil has been loosed. The chaos increases. Haunts can be activated at night. Oh, chaos. We're at 1 chaos. Fergus the Mad, great. This is the guy that steals your item drops. I have no idea how we're going to deal with Fergus. I think we're pretty much just hosed. What is that? I don't like that. How do I find out what it is? I don't know. It looks like some kind of hazard. Let's get close to it. Well, I guess we just go for it. Poison. Oh, that's nice. And it was enough to kill him. All right. Arlene, it's up to you. No pressure. But the fate of the world rests on you. Chaos has increased. Chaos is up. Alright. Fantastic. What happens if I get to my party member? Let's try it. Revive Tim. Beautiful. Chaos has increased yet again. Wow. This is getting ugly, people. We need to get to that mine right now. Found a dead adventure. I'm going to loot it. A fire tome? Yeah. Who's this, Tim? Buddy, you better equip that. That's a beautiful thing. Oh, did you see that? Leprechaun. He stole my fire tome. I hate leprechauns, I gotta tell you. Leprechauns are terrible. Pot of gold, it's a bunch of crap. I'm thinking they're more like the horror movie at this point. Once again, I really do like the art in this game. It's a good looking wolf. Very well done. Okay, it looks like he has enough to make it to the mines. We have made it to the mines. And we're going in with the whole party. We're going underground, folks. You are deep underground. Explore further. For better or for worse, that is what we're doing. Alright, a party of skeletons is ready to wreck us. Tim is on death's door. And of course they're focusing Tim. Tim, buddy, you need some healing. Like, in a serious way. I'm serious. You need to do something here, friend. Alright, so... which bone trickster is next? This guy. This is the guy who gets to act next, so we're going to attack him. We're going to blast him. You know, this may be the last move that Tim makes for a while, so I'm going to go ahead and try... nah, never mind. 65% accuracy is no good. It's blast time. There's a good guy. What's this? Slash attack. 100% to cut. How about a party heal? That seems like a good move. 5 HP. We've got a frozen party member. I don't know what that does. Oh well. A splash attack on a critical, but I'd need... yeah. We're just gonna do a normal smash. Not quite enough. Tim survives! As does Robin. Really rough crowd out here tonight. These skeletons are not nice. I'm gonna try the group attack. Low accuracy, but it might kill him and hit another. Or all of them for massive damage. I feel like I need to heal the party again. 6 HP this time. We'll take it. And it wasn't for nothing. It kept him alive. Beautiful. Alright. Here's a shockwave. This is Arlene. She's gonna focus one so that guarantees me at least 25% damage. Full shockwave. Some splash damage at that bone fighter. Yes, pick on Arlene. She's good to go. She's got armor. Look at that. That victory feels really good, I gotta be honest. Feels really good. A war axe. Oh man, yeah. I think that's nice. Plus one war axe. Oh, are you kidding me? That leprechaun is such a jerk. He stole my axe. Alright, Tim wants this frost staff. Okay, he got it. Stupid leprechaun. He's evil. What do we have in our inventory here? Got some God's Beard. Gonna use one of those. And we're gonna send another one to Tim. So that he can heal his butt. Tim, heal up. Alright. Now I know that Arlene got hit by some freezing and it said frozen, but I'm hoping that that's ended by now. I don't see anything to indicate that she's hurt. So we're gonna move on. We're out of healing items though. This is getting serious. Alright, We have a 51% chance to bash the door down. And fortune was on our side. I think I just leveled up. Look at that, 80 toughness. Whoa, did I just see some God's beard in her inventory? That's great news, because Tim could use one of those. Gonna give that to Tim. Tim's gonna use it. Now we're ready. Alright, the ghost of Jarena Khaldun, a bone fighter and a bat. Whoa! Don't pick on Robin. You guys need to pick on Arlene. Honestly. What is that minus for? Oh well. Okay, Tim. That ghost is, resistant to fire. What are you working with? Ice storm. Wow, cool. Let's try an ice storm. Are you resistant to ice? No, you're not. Okay, maybe it was, I don't know. Alright, Robin. Make it happen. One ghost down. We got a ghost down, folks. It's time to smash this bone fighter. Oh, no, don't hit him. No, you don't want to hit Robin. Robin will never forgive you. Straight up blasted him. 78% accuracy. Let's get it done. That was lame. Arlene comes through, as always. It's good to have a blacksmith in the party. Whew. Alright, I don't really see anything in my inventory that's going to help. I need to get rid of Fergus the Mad. His evil little face is just irritating me. He might take some of the treasure that's in this chest. Oh god! A mimic! Okay. This game is amazing, and I love it. I never expected that, but any game with a mimic in it has got to be good. Wow. Robin died for opening that chest. No one expects the mimic inquisition. Ha. Nothing better than that mimic. Can we just feed Robin to it? A longbow. Boy, I'd love to equip that with Robin. But Robin's dead. A fancy vest? Yes, I think so. Fergus didn't get any of our good stuff either. Whoa, what? This is the end of Farul. I've failed you, Bronner. The chaos increased to 4. Players cannot be revived and haunts can be activated at night. You telling me I can't bring Robin back to life because chaos? Come on, I'm proceeding through this dungeon with all speed. This is some harsh stuff here, folks. This game does not mess around. Stealing my loot, permanently killing off my players. Alright, we're going down a stairwell. A healing fountain? By all means. 15 HP. Yes. I like that. Onward. Okay. I think we're gonna have Arlene open this one. And it's a good thing. 12 damage. Wow. This is a brutal place. Chaos level 4 is no joke. It's like all mimics all the time up in here. Arlene might not even live through this. That's my ice staff. Good job, Tim. A fancy cap. Gonna put that on Tim. I have a bad feeling. Oh, Fergus got it. Wooden heater? Yes, I think so. Oh, Fergus. Thanks, Fergus. You jerk. On we go. Full chaos. And we gotta bash that door. Look at that. In we go. Oh, wait a minute. I'm gonna replenish some focus. We need all the focus we can get. We're focused up now. In we go. To the final chamber. We've got... Oh my. Two Bone Warriors and a Chaos Priestess. I'm not gonna say what that Chaos Priestess is looking like. Alright, so... I could go for massive damage to one. Yeah, yeah. We're gonna freeze storm these guys. Wait a minute. Critical ignores resistance. I like that. Let's critical this thing. Bam! Oh! Alright. Shockwave. 100% accuracy, 100% critical. Oh, she lived by 1 point? Oh, I almost took out a Chaos Priestess, folks. But it's not happening. And this is For the King by Iron Oak Games. My party has been defeated. We made a good run at it. We reached the end of the mines and nearly defeated the Chaos Priestess, but the quest has failed. Such a pity. And look at that little bastard, Fergus the Mad, up in the upper right corner with his wee little grin. Oh, I'm gonna steal your treasure. Hate that guy. He stole so many good items from me. One of these days I'm gonna kill him. Until then, this has been Polar Relic.